Somalia breached the MOU by objecting to CLCS consideration of Kenya's submission, only to consent again immediately before filing its memorial. According to Kenya, the withdrawal of consent was a breach of Somalia's obligations under the MOU that gave rise to significant costs and delays. Kenya also contends that a state, I quote, seeking relief before the court must come with clean hands, end of quote, and that Somalia has not done so. The court recalls that in a letter to the Secretary General of the United Nations, dated 10 October 2009, forwarded to him under cover of a letter dated 2 March 2010, Somalia requested that the MOU be treated as non-actionable. Somalia objected to consideration by the CLCS of Kenya's submission by letter dated 4 February 2014. It withdrew this objection by letter of 7 July 2015. The court observes that the fact that an applicant may have breached a treaty at issue in the case does not per se affect the admissibility of its application. Moreover, the court notes that Somalia is neither relying on the MOU as an instrument conferring jurisdiction on the court, nor as a source of substantive law governing the merits of this case. Thus, Somalia's objection to CLCS consideration of Kenya's submission does not render the application inadmissible. In the circumstances of this case, there is no need for the court to address the more general question whether there are situations in which the conduct of an applicant would be of such a character as to render its application inadmissible. In light of the foregoing, the court finds that the preliminary objection to the admissibility of Somalia's application must be rejected. For these reasons, the court, 1A, by 13 votes to 3, rejects the first preliminary objection raised by the Republic of Kenya, insofar as it is based on the Memorandum of Understanding of 7 April 2009. In favor, President Abraham, Vice President Yusuf, Judges Owada, Tomka, Cansado Trindade, Greenwood, Choué, Donohue, Gaya, Sebutinde, Bandari, Crawford, Gevorgian. Against, Judges Benuna, Robinson, Judge Ad Hoc, Guillaume. B, by 15 votes to 1, rejects the first preliminary objection raised by the Republic of Kenya, insofar as it is based on Part 15 of the United Nations Convention on the Law of the Sea. In favor, President Abraham, Vice President Yusuf, Judges Owada, Tomka, Benuna, Cansado Trindade, Greenwood, Choué, Donohue, Gaya, Sebutinde, Bandari, Crawford, Gevorgian, Judge Ad Hoc, Guillaume. Against, Judge Robinson. 2, by 15 votes to 1, rejects the second preliminary objection raised by the Republic of Kenya. In favor, President Abraham, Vice President Souf, Judges Owada, Tomka, Benuna, Cansado Trindade, Greenwood, Choué, Donohue, Gaya, Sebutinde, Bandari, Crawford, Gevorgian, Judge Ad Hoc, Guillaume. Against, Judge Robinson. 3, by 13 votes to 3, finds that it has jurisdiction to entertain the application filed by the Federal Republic of Somalia on 28 August 2014, and that the application is admissible. In favor, President Abraham, Vice President Yusuf, Judges Owada, Tomka, Cansado Trindade, Greenwood, Choué, Donohue, Gaya Sebutinde, Bandari, Crawford, Gevorgian. Against, Judges Benuna, Robinson, Judge Ad Hoc, Guillaume. I shall now call upon the registrar to read the operative part of the judgment in French.
Par ces motifs, la Cour, 1-1 par 13 voix contre 3, rejette la première exception préliminaire soulevée par la République du Kenya en tant qu'elle est fondée sur le mémorandum d'accord du 7 avril 2009. Pour M. Abraham, président, M. Youssouf, vice-président, M. Wada Tomka Kansa de Trindade, Greenwood, Mme Choué, Donahue, M. Gaya, Mme Seboutinde, M. Bandari, Crawford, Gevorgian, juge. Contre, M. Benouna, Robinson, juge, M. Guillaume, juge ad hoc. B. Par 15 voix contre 1. Rejette la première exception préliminaire soulevée par la République du Kenya en tant qu'elle est fondée sur la partie 15 de la Convention des Nations Unies sur le droit de la mer. Pour, M. Abraham, président,